ओके, टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी ऑल आर स्टडिंग अबाउट कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशन इन थ्री डायमेंशनल फ्लो. इन फर्स्ट मॉड्यूल वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशन इन ऑफ ए फ्लूइड फ्लो, दैट इज द A1V1 is equal to A2V2 is equal to constant. Now, but here in this lecture we are discussing about a three-dimensional flow of a fluid flow. Now, rate of flow or discharge, it is very important because the discharge is a flowing properties, but it is a quantitative property already. Therefore, rate of flow or discharge is defined as the quantity of a liquid flowing per second through a section, a pipe or channel, or a given channel. It is generally denoted by Q. Let us consider that a liquid flowing through a pipe. Okay, therefore let us assume cross-sectional area of a pipe is capital A, and velocity of the liquid, average velocity of the liquid is capital V. Therefore the discharge is equal to area, cross-sectional area multiplied by the velocity, which is shown in here. This is the shown in here, this diagram, that is the Q is equal to A into B, where A is the cross-sectional area and V is the velocity, that is the average velocity. Therefore if area is in meter, we taken in a channel or a pipe flow, and velocity is taken as in a meter per second, therefore the discharge velocity, the unit of the discharge is to be meter square into meter per second, that is the meter cube per second, or which is called as a Q max. Okay, therefore now we come on the continuity equation. Okay, it states that the continuity equation is based on the principle of conservation of mass. The continuity equation is completely based on the conservation of mass, and Bernoulli equation is based on the principle of conservation of energy, which is fluently asking about in any competitive examinations as well as GATE, as many competitive purposes. It states as follows: if no fluid is no fluid is added or removed from the pipe in any length, then the mass passing across different sections, one sections and two sections, different sections, shall be same. Okay, in next slides we see a pipe is taken here, flow through a pipe, that is the section 1-1 and section 2-2 in the given pipe. Now let us assume two sections, that is the 1-1 section and 2-2 sections in a given figure, here 1-1 section and here 2-2 sections in that diagram. Let a section 1-1 have the cross-sectional velocity is capital A1, and the velocity, average velocity of the fluid at section 1-1 is capital V1, and the density of the fluid, flowing fluid, is at the section 1-1 is taken as the rho 1. Similarly, we can say about the section 2.2 have the velocity, the cross-sectional area A2, the velocity capital V2, and the density is rho 2 corresponding to the section 2.2. Therefore, the total quantity of the fluid passing through a section 1.1 is equal to rho 1 A1, which is see in picture here, rho 1 A1 V1, and the total quantity of fluid passing through section 2.2, which is see here, 2.2 section, is how much? This is the rho 2 A2 and V2, we see here. Okay? Therefore, according to the application, according to the mass of conservation, law of conservation of mass, that is the matter theorem of the continuity, which is known as in the state forms, previously we all understand that is the theorem of continuity, that is the principle of conservation of mass. Therefore, according to the principle of conservation of mass, the total fluid passing through section 1.1, which is equal to fluid passing through section 2.2. And now, equating both values, the section 1.1 and section 2.2, we have, which is see here, that is the rho 1 A1 V1 is equal to rho 2 A2 V2. Okay? Now here, the fluid is compressible as well as incompressible fluids and is called continuity equations, because the fluid is incompressible in that condition, and we all are know. In first module, we all are just discussing about incompressible flow, compressible flow. Okay. Therefore, in fluid case, the liquid is incompressible and gas is compressible. Okay. We take a large quantity of gas, for example, LPG cylinder. The large quantity of gas we fill in the cylinder with any technique, but the large amount of water is to be not filled in that container, in that LPG cylinder, because the liquid, that is the water or liquid, is incompressible. Therefore, rho 1 is equal to rho 2, and then we have the continuity equation is A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. Okay. Now for a simple example we taken in given below, that is the diameter of a pipe at the section 1.1 and 2.2 are 200 and 300 millimeter respectively. If the velocity of water flowing through the pipe at section 1.1 is 4 meter per second, therefore find first one is the discharge through the pipe and second one is the velocity of water section 2.2. Okay. The pipe is similar to the above figure, that is the section 1.1 is diameter is lesser, that is the 200 millimeter, and the section 2.2 is diameter is larger, that is the 300 millimeter. Okay. Now we come on the solution part. This is the figure and section 1.1 and section 2.2. Diameter D1 is equal to 200 millimeter and diameter D2 is equal to here, which is seen picture, that is the 300 millimeter. Therefore, now we calculate firstly diameter d1 is equal to 200 millimeter, which is converted into meter. That is the multiply by 10 to the power minus 2, and which 10 to the power minus 3, we get 0.2 meter. Therefore, the cross sectional area at section 1-1 is to be calculated, that is the pi by 4 d1 is square, and putting the value of diameter at the section 1-1 is 0.2 meter. We calculate the above quantity. We have the cross sectional area at section 1-1 is 0.03314 meter square, and velocity already given at that section, that is the v1 is equal to 4 meter per second. Okay, now again the diameter of the pipe at section 2-2 is given as 300 millimeter, which is already also converted in the meter, that is the multiply by 10 to the power minus 3. Therefore, the diameter of the pipe at section 2-2 is to be 0.3 meter. And now area is calculated at the section 2-2 is to be pi by 4 d2 square, putting the value of diameter d is 0.3 meter, and solving this, then we get 0.0707 meter square, which is area, cross-sectional area at the section 2-2. Therefore, the first, now the come on the first part of this question. First of the question, given in the question, asking in the question, discharge through the pipe is how much? Therefore, now according to continuity equation, the discharge at section 1-1 is equal to the discharge at section 2-2 is equal to constant value, which is similar value. Therefore, A1 V1 is equal to capital Q, where capital Q is the discharge. Putting these values, we see in here the picture, that is the A1 V1. Cross sectional area at section 1-1 is 0.0314, and velocity at section 1-1 is 4. Therefore, we calculate the discharge at section 1-1 is equal to how much, which is 0.1256 meter cube per second. This is the discharge at section 1-1. Therefore, now come on second part of the question, that is the velocity of water at section 2-2. Okay, therefore, using the continuity equation and the above relation, A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. We have the calculate we ask about in that question, that is the velocity at section 2-2 is how much, that is the V2, and V2 is equal to, which is right here, V2 is equal to A1 V1 upon A2, and putting the all values above, we calculate already. Therefore, the velocity at section 2-2, V2 is equal to 1.77 meter per second. That is the answer. And now complete the question. We asking about the above question. First part is discharge, and second part is the velocity at the section 2-2. Therefore, the discharge of the pipe at any section is calculated to be 0.1256 meter cube per second, that is the Qmax, and the velocity at section 2-2, which is also calculated, and how much value? This is the 1.77 meter per second. Okay, now I come on the equation, next part of the next topic of the this lecture, that is the continuity equation in Cartesian coordinates. Okay, that is a three-dimensional flow of the fluid. In given diagram, the pictures represents, that is the here x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis. All are among mutually perpendicular to the each other. and meet at the point is where, that is the point OO here, which is all our meet the point O and meet mutually perpendicular, like that. We see like that, x axis, y axis and z axis. Okay, now we take a continuum part, that is the fluid element in three dimensional flow, that is the A, B, C, D, E, F and G, and last one is the H point. We all are see in that pictures. Okay, the dimension of the fluid part element about x axis is we taken as dx, and y axis about dy, and z axis about dz. We all are see in pictures, that is there here. Okay, now therefore let us, the density of the fluid flow in the given fluid element, that is a rho, is equal to mass density of the fluid at a particular instant, any time. Small u, v and w, which see in here, that is here we see u, v, w is equal to component of velocity of flow entering the three faces of the parallelepipeds. Okay, all are parallel, about parallelepipeds. Therefore, the rate of mass of fluid entering the face, which face? A, B, C, D. That is the we shown in previous picture. That is the which is called fluid influx. Okay, that is the here we see in the picture, that is the A, P, C and D. A, B, C and D. This phase are called fluid influx. Okay, and the fluids passes this phase like that, as this type, this way passes through this direction. Okay, x, y, z direction. Therefore, the rate of fluid entering this phase is how much? That is the density into velocity into cross-sectional area. Therefore, density is rho, velocity is in x direction, which is taken, that is the u, and the area of the this section is taken as a, b, c, d of the area of that section. Okay, therefore we can write rho u dy dz. Dy and dz is the cross sectional area of the a, b, c, d, and u is the velocity of x direction. Okay, therefore we write here rho u dy into dz. Therefore, rate of mass of fluid leaving the phase E, F, G, H, which is seen in the diagram above here, this phase. Rate of mass of fluid leaving this phase, that is the E, F, G, H, that is the fluid efflux, influx entering phase, and efflux exit phase. Okay, now in next year we all are studying in environmental engineering, when the wastewater enter in treatment plant initially, then this fluids, entering fluids, wastewater are called influent. And when the wastewater passes after the treatment of the treatment plant is to be said to be effluent. Similarly, here when the fluid entering this phase ABCD are called fluid influx, and when the fluid passes over exit over the phase EFGH are called fluid efflux. Understand? Therefore, rho U dy dz is already the entering phase, plus which quantity of the mass of the fluid is added on that portion, that is the partial derivatives of this whole function. We come on the equation. Here we see here this part is previously, that is the entering at the phase ABCD, influent efflux, influx, and after entering the fluid travel dx distance to how much the quantity of fluid mass. Therefore, difference part that we taken the partial derivatives of that quantity with respect to dx, del x. And we can write del upon del del x, that is the rho u dy dz into dx, that is the partial derivatives of the influx with respect to dx. Okay, now the gain in mass per unit time due to flow in x direction is given by the difference between the fluid influx and fluid efflux. Differences between both. Therefore, mass accumulated per unit time due to flow in x direction, which is as see here or right here, that is the difference of fluid influx and fluid efflux. We can write here rho u dy dz minus in within bracket rho u plus del upon del x rho u dx outer bracket whole bracket, that is the dy into dz. We can write first minus and plus part is cut it out and gives out negative times is here this value, that is the minus times del upon del x rho u dx dy and dz. Okay, similarly the gain in fluid mass per unit time in the parallelopipes, which is taken as A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, that is the parallelopipes, parallelogram. The due to flow in y direction and z direction is to be written as minus times here, which is see here, del minus times del upon del y rho v dx dy dz, and in z direction, which is right here, minus times del upon del z rho w dx dy dz. Okay, now therefore the total mass, that is the total gain in fluid mass per unit of per unit for fluid along three coordinates. Okay, that is the x, y, z coordinates. Okay, we can write the summation of all three components of the fluid mass per unit time. Therefore, minus times is taken as out of the bracket, and we write here del upon del x rho u plus del upon del y rho v plus del upon del z rho w, and within completely total in within taken we taken in a bracket and d multiply by dx dy dz. Okay, now the rate of change of mass of the parallelepipeds, that is the control volume. Only we study about the controlled volume, that is the A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, which is fluid flow, is continuously flow, continuous flow, and head is maintained, that is the pressure is maintained. Therefore, the rate of change of mass is how much? That is the del upon del T, rho dx dy dz. And this value is equal to the total gain in fluid mass. Equating both equations, we see here that is the minus times del upon del x rho u plus del upon del y rho v plus del upon del z rho w within bracket multiply by dx dy dz, and which is equal to del upon del t rho dx dy dz. Cut it some terms, that is the dx dy dz is also cut it out, and rho is already cutting. Del upon del t is remaining part, and rho is also taken as remaining, not cutting in right side to left side. Therefore, simplifying the rearrangement of the above term, and we expressed like that: del upon del x rho u plus del upon del y rho v plus del upon del z rho w plus del rho upon del t is equal to 0. Okay, understand? Okay, now in general equation of continuity in three dimensions and is applicable to any type of flow and for any fluid, whether compressible or incompressible fluid flow. For steady flow, del rho upon del t is equal to 0, that is the incompressible fluid, rho is equal to constant. The equation is to be written as, the above equation is written as del u upon del x plus del v upon del y plus del z del w upon del y, which is equal to 0. This is the three-dimensional flow of the continuity equation of the fluid flow. And when the in the case of two-dimensional flow, del z axis is already goes to 0. Therefore, the equation is for two-dimensional flow, we can write del u upon del x plus del v upon del y, which is equal to 0. This is the two-dimensional fluid flow of the liquid in the continuity equation. And in one-dimensional flow, say in x direction equation, we taken in the form of del u upon del x is equal to 0, that is the y-axis component and z-axis component, velocity component is to be taken as 0, that is the v is equal to 0 and w is equal to 0, we see in here. Okay, therefore integrating with respect to x, we get u is equal to constant, and if the area of flow is A, then the rate of flow is how much? Q is equal to A into U. This is constant for steady flow, and which is the continuity equation, which is the same as states that if the area of flow A is constant, the velocity of flow U will also be constant value, which is the above is continuity equation in one dimensional flow, two-dimensional flow and three-dimensional flow. In one-dimensional continuity equation flow is del u upon del x is equal to 0, that is the velocity component as y-axis and z-axis, that is the u V and W is equal to 0, and in two dimensional flow, that is the del U of del U upon del X plus del V upon del Y is equal to 0, and here the velocity component of Z axis is 0, that is the W is equal to 0, and in three dimensional continuity equation is written as del U upon del X plus del U V upon del Y plus del Z up del W upon del Y del W upon del Z is equal to 0, which is the continuity equation in three dimensional flow. Okay, now next one is the equation of continuity in polar coordinate, which is very important. That is the in polar form, that is the theta and radius terminology. Okay, consider a fluid element given in diagram L, M, T, S as shown in figure. Here L, M, T and S, okay, which is a consider a fluid element in radial or axial, both component. LT is equal to MS is equal to DR. We see in a diagram, that is the DR right here, DR. Therefore LM is how much? That is the basic equation, basic geometry. Angle is equal to arc upon radius. Angle is equal to, that is the theta is equal to arc, that is arc upon radius. Basic equation in previous classes, 10th, 11th, 12th or 8th, basic geometry, that is the angle is equal to arc upon radius. We apply and we get LM is equal to R into theta, where theta is how much? That is the d theta we taken in the diagram. Therefore ST is how much? ST is equal to R plus dr into d theta, because the radius is to be r to dr, therefore r plus dr. Therefore total radius is how much? That is the r plus dr. Okay, understand? Therefore the st is equal to how much? R plus dr into d theta. Let v suffix r is component of the velocity in the radial direction, and v theta is equal to, that is the v theta suffix, theta is taken to be suffix form, and that is the v theta is equal to component of the velocity in the tangential direction. Okay, further let thickness of the element perpendicular to the plane of the paper be unity, as the third flows through the element, changes will place in its velocity as well as in the density. Okay, we see in diagram, complete diagram, that is the v theta, that is the radial tangential velocity, and the section and after d theta radial radius may, therefore the radial velocity is v theta plus del v theta upon del theta into d theta, and the radius is how much? R dr, r plus dr. Okay, this is the control volume of the section of the equation of the continuity in polar coordinates. Okay, now in fluid flow in radial direction, okay, mass of fluid entering the phase LM During the time dt is given by how much, that is the fluid flux is equal to density into velocity into area into time. In Cartesian coordinates, time is not taken, but in polar coordinate we already taken as the time component. That is the four dimension, okay, like a four dimensional flow. Therefore, density is how much, that is the rho, we see in diagram, we see in equation, that is the here, we see in here, density is rho into Vr into r d theta into time is dt. Therefore, mass of fluid leaving the phase AST during the same time dt is given by how much, that is the fluid efflux, here influx, here efflux is here, rho Vr plus del upon del r rho Vr dr within bracket multiply by r plus dr into d theta into dt. This is the efflux, fluid efflux. Now mass accumulated in the element because of the flow in the radial direction, that is the fluid influx minus fluid efflux. Okay, subtracting both and putting here, we see, and now neglecting the term containing dr whole square, and we get minus times rho Vr dr d theta plus del upon del r rho Vr dr d theta whole bracket dt. Therefore, the flow in taken as the tangential directions. Now the flow is taken as tangential directions. We see here, we all are seeing here this one, okay. The mass accumulated due to the flow in the tangential direction by a similar treatment as discussed earlier, that is the rho v theta dr minus within bracket rho v theta plus del upon del theta rho v theta d theta within bracket multiply by d theta and whole within bracket dr and completely square bracket we taken, then multiply by d theta, which is equal to minus times del d theta del upon del theta rho v theta dr d theta dt, which is right here, okay. Therefore, total gain in fluid mass is equal to solving above, and we have final the equation is, which is C here 1, that is the minus times within bracket minus times within bracket rho Vr plus del upon del r rho Vr r plus del upon del theta rho V theta square within bracket dr d theta dt. Also, the rate of change of fluid mass in the element LMST is equal to del upon del t into density into volume multiply by dt. That is the rate of change. And putting these values and equating the above as per the law of conservation of mass, we get here, that is the total gain in mass is equal to the rate of change of fluid mass in the element LMST, that is the equating the above both equations, and we have. Therefore, for steady and incompressible full flow, del upon del t rho r d theta dr is equal to 0, which is see here is equal to 0. Therefore, rho Vr plus del upon del r rho Vr r plus del upon del theta rho V theta multiply within square bracket multiply dr into d theta is equal to, which is equal to 0. Further, for incompressible flow, rho is equal to constant value and not, which is not equal to 0. Rho is not equal to 0, that is the rho is constant. Therefore, Vr plus del upon del r Vr into multiply by r plus del upon del theta V theta is equal to 0. Now we can write वी आर अपान आर प्लस डेल वी आर अपान डेल आर प्लस डेल वी थीटा अपान आर डेल थीटा विच इज सी हियर. दिस इज द पोलर कोऑर्डिनेट. दिस इज द कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशंस इन द टर्म्स ऑफ कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशन इन द टर्म्स ऑफ पोलर कोऑर्डिनेट्स. दैट इज द वी आर अपान आर प्लस डेल वी आर अपान डेल आर प्लस डेल वी थीटा अपान आर डेल थीटा विच इज इक्वल टू बी जीरो. एंड दिस इज द ओवर. नाउ